things he is doing amidst us, in our nations, and I'm telling you, the islands of the sea, as well as in the global village, which is the entire world. We give him glory, we give him honor, we give him praise. Amen?
Amen.
Put your hands together for Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. And I must say, we thank God again for the missions that we have done by Bull Bay on Monday, which was a Hero's Day. God showed me that platform before. He showed me the Jamaican fabric, which they call, I don't remember, what is the name of the Jamaican fabric that they normally use?
Bandana.
The bandana. I thought what they tie on the hair is called bandana. I kind of confused that. Okay, bandana with a bull horn. That's what he showed me. To do it on Heroes Day. I mean, but by the time I saw the bandana thing, I'm like, okay, this is Jamaican national thing. So I asked the people and they said, Heroes Day. That is what happened at Heroes Day. And plus he showed me some other stuff, so I said, better take it to Heroes Day, because I was trying for my 33 missions anniversary in Jamaica. I'm over 33 years now in the island of the sea. And so I wanted to celebrate that week to do the branching out of the church right there. But it was not possible, because when I got there, I kept saying, oh my God, the place was so bush that if they throw somebody inside, you will not see that person again. I said, oh my God, I cannot do anything. I called people, come and help me in the bush. The cost they gave to me, oh my God. And even right now, I'm going down that road in terms of the costing, because my God, the first thing they said, 60,000. I said, to just the bush? They said, yes, it's grown. I need money, left, right, and center to do that thing. But God help us, we spent money. I have to fix the government road that leads to the community, because it was eroded, it was erosion, it was all kind of gully, hill and gully, hill and gully. And in order to make the driving easier, I had to buy cement and get workmen who are almost tearing me in pieces. They want money before they even do anything, before they leave the stone. They want money and all kinds of stuff. But to God be the glory that we were able to do a service right there in the community. People who understood, they came out and they supported. And we have been trying, hey. Some people thought we're going to be doing that from time to time. I said, we want to start a church there. But I need people to identify who want to be members of the church. So if I get enough people to start, then we're going to be going there like 11 o'clock. We're going to be having services there every Sunday. As we finish there from 8 to 10 or 10:30, then we're going to be running there on a Sunday basis until then. To God be the glory. Greetings, guys. The place also is going to be the Revival Village, is the campsite. A Revival Village campsite where other churches can rent and use for to stay there. They have to be sleeping over. So I'm also trying to really build the place so that people can sleep over and so on and so forth. May the Lord help us. May the Lord help me. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. And for you who came out, God is going to bless you again and again. Amen?
Amen.
We are all building the kingdom of God. In an era in the world, in the dispensation where sin is as black as can be and as dark, and people are entering into darkness and doing all hanky-panky things, and the church is involved in it. Oh my God, I can't believe it. I was interviewed as I went inside, as I was driving last Friday. I got a call from Observer. There are several articles I've written that weren't published. Many were published and some not published. And sometimes when I ask them, they tell me, my God, that article is too heavy for us. We cannot publish that. It's just too heavy. And I'm like, but no, this is happening. But then they called me as I was driving and they want to interview me on Halloween. And by the time I gave them a time, I thought I would be home then, but alas, I was at tax office. When they called me back, I said, boy, I can't wait. That was the first thing on the going to be talking about why should a church be having a crusade against Halloween. Halloween. I said, yes, this is my picture that they are put that kicking out, kicking against Halloween. That Jamaicans are gone after Halloween. I was interviewed about 2 or 3 years ago on Love FM about the same thing. And I said, Jamaica should not support Halloween. The church on a global level must not support Halloween, because the root cause of Halloween is devilish. It's coming from the grave. It's coming from the grave. And I'm saying that it's coming from the grave.
That's right. Amen.
It's coming from the grave. Those who started it, they started because they said that the souls of those who died, we want to come back to visit. And so they want to disguise themselves so that when those dead spirits come back, they do not identify them. So they put up all kinds of stuff now to disguise themselves. And they use this fruit. Is it pumpkin? Pumpkin and some other stuff and some sweet and some whatever in order to disguise themselves so that when the dead comes back, they will not identify who they are, because they want to disguise themselves. It's done in Europe, it's done in America, it's done all kinds of places. And the church? The church that's supposed to be the light is joining Halloween and having Halloween party. And this pastor, he is talking about, oh my God. And I'm going to read a little, just a few of what is here. And if you don't have a copy, get your copy. Whenever I write an article, I encourage people to get copies of the cleaner. Actually, I always publish my articles more than the Observer. And sometimes both of them publish the same article. And people are calling me, I saw your article in the cleaner. And then I saw it in the Observer. I said, oh, glory be to God. And just for the truth to go out there. God said to us many years ago, he said, I want to make you the pillar of the truth. The pillar of the truth. And I want to make you the Antioch church. The church that give precedence, instructions to other churches. And that is what God has made this church to be. You might come now. You don't see a lot of people. It used to have a lot of people. When my husband was alive. They called him to every, whenever there is a problem. That's when they call us. On TV, on the radio. If you check our history in the past, all kinds of things. Oh, why is that happening? Oh my God, why are we having an accident on our road? Oh, why is it that the man kill his wife and kill himself? The man cook the wife and cook himself. Hello, don't ask me about that. The man cook the wife and cook himself. But what am I saying? They always come to when anytime there's a problem, they are calling to find out. Why is it so? I'm going to read. Bishop Dr. Blessed Adigol is calling on Christians to rise up and condemn the demonic celebration. While Anglican priest Sean Major Campbell believes the church has bigger issues to tackle within its own walls. In other words, than tackling Halloween. In a fiery call to action, Bishop Adigol said that the celebration, which is observed in many countries on October 31, is rooted in demonic principles and evokes evil spirits, which will cause further chaos in Jamaica. The church should speak against it. The church should rise up against it. Unfortunately, there are some churches that cannot discern to see that this is devilish. And so they participate by also putting on the costumes and doing parties and all kinds of stuff. People have to be taught. They have to be enlightened about these things, that it is devilish, said the founding president of Arashai Apostolic and Deliverance Ministries. We must not participate in it. Wow. Let's open our Bibles. Hallelujah. Let's open our Bibles to the book of 2 Corinthians. 2 Corinthians. Can I be excused to just for me to move around properly to I'll take off my shoe. Well, little Bible takes off my shoe sometimes. So how going to take off my shoe even right now. 2 Corinthians, hallelujah, chapter 10. Amen. 2 Corinthians chapter 10 from verse 3. Shall we read it together? 1, 2, go. For though we walk in the flesh, we do not war after the flesh. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imaginations and everything kind that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ, and having in our readiness to revenge all disobedience when our obedience is fulfilled. The works of the flesh is what push those who founded Halloween. Those who founded those who danced during Easter. What do they call them again? Remember those who danced the carnival. The Bible is outrightly opposed to it. We prayed against this some years ago. God took away the man that started it. But lo and behold, they still haven't given it up. Masquerading and revealing, party spirit, and all kinds of things. And people are doing it. You can imagine, you as an adult are supposed to mentor your children, to tell them what is good and what is not good. And all of a sudden, you said there is carnival. And you expose yourself, and you went on this thing, and you dance all kinds of hideous, and in the front of the children. I can remember one day when the church was at 15 Packington Plaza, because they always do it every Sunday and block the roads. So we're trying so high, so much to reach Packington Plaza when we came to church. Oh Jesus, I can't tell you what happened that day. Maybe let me tell you. At least it will make you laugh a little. As I reached the, I was living by off Waterloo. And as I Washington Drive, as I reached almost where the Canadian embassy was, the police blocked the road. The police said, go back. They said, go this way. So I went that way as they were directing other vehicles and went far and came out by, I don't even remember the road, Lady Musgrave, Trafalgar, and came to the hotel that is, it used to be Sutton Place Hotel, now North Fort Worth Hotel. That is the road behind North Fort Worth Hotel. I cannot remember that name, the name of that road right now. And then somebody jumped inside, somebody just opened my car, help me. And he jumped inside my car and said, let's go to the hotel, So we drove into the hotel. And people know that road, the back of that hotel. Our administrator knows that road properly. I don't remember the name. We are Holborn Road. You know Holborn Road is? When you go on Holborn Road, is the back of the North Fort Court Hotel. Chelsea. So and he said, let's go into the hotel. So we went and blew and they opened. He said, let's pass through the hotel. So we drove. I drove through the hotel and he said, emergency. Just put on your emergency light. So I said, what happened? I put it on, lady, put on your emergency light. So I put on the emergency light, and so as we were passing, driving through the hotel, it was taking us to, what is the name of that road that you come into? That is where JPS is. What is the name of that road? We came to Ruthven Road. Before we came to reach Ruthven Road, it was hundreds of people on the road. Going. The man said, that's why I asked him to put on the emergency light. Emergency. But the man said, the poo pushed down his window. Emergency. And everybody began to flick themselves out of the room. Emergency. And some people said, what? And some people laid down on, when I was going down, some laid themselves on my car and said, drag me with the car because I'm right now, I'm tired. Just drag. The man said, no, emergency. everybody put off. I mean, pull off. The police move. They pull up their whatever they are. They pull it off. And then when the man reached where he want to come off, he said, "Now, lady, thank you. I'm off now. You don't have to put on emergency light. You don't want to put it on. But right now, I put it on." And the man let me and go. That was how I was able to come through and reach halfway through. I mean, reach. Yes, I came out of the Aden, and you know the Aden road, and I came out of that and went around and came to 17 packets, I mean 15 packets of blood. I was breathing heavily. I said, "Lord, I never know what." Because why? Those people feel the road. Yes. Some people feel the road and they will not allow it to pass. When we finished and we were going home, and as we were going back, I went on the same GPS road to go home. As we are almost going to reach Trafalgar, they covered the road. And what I saw in front of me was the nakedness of women. And I was like, "What is this? What is this? These are devilish things. Every thought of man, everything that hinders the move of the gospel in Jamaica and in the island of the sea, we bring them down now in the name of the fire and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name." Amen.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Jesus is Lord. And if he stopped the entire nation, if it is Christian thing, oh my God, you have to blow the trumpet 100,000 times for people to join you. But if it is something evil, yes, something of darkness, before you know it, people are congregating. It doesn't matter if they have to pay 10,000, if they have to pay 20,000, if they have to pay 30,000, people will be saving their money towards it. Oh Jesus. Every thought of man that does not submit to the obedience of Christ, we pull them down right now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Put your hands together for Jesus. And when we, you shall not prosper. And when we, you shall no more prosper in the entire nation of the earth, of the world, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Say amen. I went to West Palm Beach some years ago, and I want to buy some stuff. I just went for 1 week, and then I said, "Okay, let me go to the stores and buy some stuff." But it was Halloween time, so the place, the business place I was taken to, a lot of shops and businesses, but they all already marked themselves for Halloween. So I said, "Listen to me, are there no shops or items that people can buy without Halloween?" And she said to me, "You know what? The Halloween people, Satan said, they want Halloween to surpass Christmas." I said, "Really? They want Halloween to surpass Christmas?" I said, "Christmas is all about the birth of the Creator. Because Jesus Christ, the second person in Trinity, the Bible says in the book of John, chapter 1, it says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God with God, and the Word was God." He said, "The same was in the beginning with God." He said, "All things were made by Him, and without Him, nothing would have been made that was made, and in Him is life." I said, they are competing with the wrong person.
That's right.
They want Halloween to surpass that, and then the church people are supporting Halloween and having party. You know, there are some people, if you call spiritual warfare, they're not coming there. "Oh, don't call me. Oh, I don't read that name." But when they hear some masquerading, when they hear some run, pay and run, what they call them, some running stuff, and people pay 5,000 to run. How many call this again? Huh? Marathon. And they pay to go and run. Nobody say that it's for an end, a cause or something. Uh-huh. But it doesn't matter what cause you are doing in the church, they have a problem. But if somebody should come with gathering and manipulate the atmosphere, hello, and say, I want somebody to write their next salary, write a check or run to the ATM and pull your next salary or borrow something and come and put it here because you have shown us they are ready to do so. You don't understand what I'm talking about. Of course, I know you understand what I'm talking about. The church has embraced so much darkness. Sometimes you've got to open our eyes. You see people sitting down in the church and it's a snake that sits there. And the individual don't even know that this snake has taken them over so much. And you see snake sitting down in the clothes of the individual. I come against every snake spirit. I will not stop. I will not even, I won't pass over that. I come against every snake spirit. Whatever the name of the snake is that has come with the people, whether those who did deliverance or those who are worshiping right now, it doesn't matter what kind of snake you are. You might be a, oh my God, tell me the names of those. You might be a bow bow, you might be a cobra, you might be whatever your name is. I come against snake spirit in the life of the people right now, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, amen. Woo! Wow. Wow. Jesus is Lord. Satan is terrible. He will sneak into the life of an individual and begin to manipulate them. Somebody who is not like that before, who doesn't behave like they are behaving now, they begin to behave like that and you'll be like, what? What is that? Because one man slept. Woo! One man slept. The enemy came and saw tears. And you don't know, and you wake up because you didn't know that there is a place that is left open. And as I'm talking, I've seen a lizard. And the side of the lizard is cut. It's cut and it has somebody's car key. And before you go in your car, we'll be having all kinds of problems. I come against every lizard spirit, every reptile spirit that is causing leaks and leaks and leaks and car problems. I come against it right now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, say amen. Amen. Woo! Satan, you cannot prevail. Satan, you can't prevail. And I say, see that lizard. I call for the fire of God, the consuming fire, according to Hebrews 12:29. For our God is a consuming fire to consume that reptile, that lizard, be burned right now. That lizard, be burned now. In the name of the Father and of the Son. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I'm hearing every remnant shall be saved. Remnants. Remnants are those who are left after everybody has gone on their ways or are carried away with their own lust or God allowed them to be carried away. Then there shall be a remnant. God called us a remnant some years ago because some people left us. God said, we are remnants. We are remnants. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I come against every pillar. Aye, aye, aye. I'm hearing recklessness in driving. Every reckless driving. I come against it right now in the island. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. we are moving towards Christmas. And that is when the evil people start to come out more and to cause accidents. I come against every accident plot of the devil in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Say amen.
Amen.
It shall not work if they use their imagination. We cancel their imagination that is not about God in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Say amen. Hallelujah. Jesus is Lord. Every hanky-panky spirit, every spirit of breaking in to people's places. Oh God, shut up. Oh my God. Oh God, what robbery. We come against them right now in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Oh my God, all pastors that have forgotten about the light of the world, that are promoting evil, may the Lord open their eyes to see in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Say amen.
Amen.
That the ones that persecute people like me, they persecute people like me. And if they hear that their members come to my church, for their eyes to be opened, for their wounds to be healed. I've seen somebody stone with a big open wound, a plaster. Is it plaster or bandage? That pinkish one. It's placed on it, and I see it open. Because there are, it's a wound, a big wound. It's been a good while. You know when a wound has taken too long? That's what I'm seeing right now. Jesus! Hey! I'm seeing something pour on it. Something pour on it like an antibiotic. In my country, there are some antibiotics that you don't have to go to the doctors to prescribe. They are sold uncounter. They call them uncounter drugs. And so you can pour it, it's a black and white. Red and black. That's the color. Red and black. An antibiotic. Red and black. When you pull it and pour it on open sore, open wound, it helps it to heal quickly. I just saw something being poured on it. Father, please, it healed. I don't hear what you say. But they don't sell it without you going to see a doctor. They sell it just like that. Oh, Jesus. Father, Lord, I just pray that that wound be healed. That wound be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed. Be healed.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. I know I have been wounded. Bad. Terribly. And left to die. And cried out, Lord, help me. God, help me. Not because I stole anybody's husband. Not because I stole anybody's money. Not that I broke into somebody's account or broke into a bank or something, but I was persecuted because I speak the truth. I don't know what the truth that I'm speaking. Some people said, boy, I run a place that I do not allow shacking up people to come there. And the same place where you come to my church, I do not encourage people single coming to my church to be having fun with men, to be in some relationship and all kinds of things that have sinful nature. And people hate that. They hate that. Some pastors don't even touch that because they want the people, they don't want to lose the people. But I talk about it because all I'm here for is about the mission that God has called me for. And I'm not afraid of the gospel of grace, for it is the power of God unto salvation. Just like Paul says. Hallelujah. So I will talk about it. Some people curse me. They say, you can't go into people's business. You are doing business. Just do business and keep quiet. I say, really? Married people want to rent my place for their sweetheart. You don't understand what I'm talking about. I'm not going to help anybody to break their marriage. Hello? You don't get me. You don't hear me. I'm not going to help any marriage to break up. If it was right in the first place, if anything has to be said, that should be said under the gospel in counseling. If they come and say, oh, we are having problems because so and so and so, that's different. Amen. But for people that are married and they want to have, I don't know, it's not sweetheart, it's sinful heart. They want to keep them right my place for them, put them there while they have their wives at home. Oh, no, go. I don't go there. Some people don't like it. It doesn't matter how much money they want to offer me, I don't take it. Somebody came all the way from England some years ago. They called me from the hotel. Four Seasons Hotel. Oh, I have a friend here and I saw your place in the glitter and I want to rent my place. And I said, fine. Oh, okay, my friend's gonna call you. And right after, the friend called me, who's a female. The person who called me first was a male. And I said, ha, it's his friend. So I said, okay, I'm at 15 packets of plaza. You know, it's in the business, same business. So the woman came to see me. The driver brought her. So we discussed. And the woman said, you know, I'm a healer. And da-da-da-da-da. I want to extend, you know, from that place to here. And I want to at least stay for 6 months first. And it is working now. And then, and if your place can have, you know, allow me to do such and such. And I said, oh yeah, I have a, you know, the patio section can be used for that. And we discussed. But then I said to her, I said, but the person who called me, I was expecting that it was a friend that was going to call me. I said, oh no, that's my friend. We've been friends for a good while. I'm living in England. And he lives here in Jamaica. I said, but are you married? She said, well, yeah. But that marriage broke up, so I don't really, I'm not in that marriage right now. I said, but did this man that is your friend, is he married? Oh yes, he's married. And they live in St. Catherine. But then he's going to be visiting me anyway. So I said, you mean like sleepover kind of a situation? She said, yes. I said, oh, please. I don't take people like that. What? What do you mean? I mean, I can pay you for 6 months just like that. I said, it's not about the money. I said, I need the money, but it's not about the money for you to pay me for 6 months. Because I will be helping to break that man's marriage. So I'm not going to do that. She was really around? But I'm a healer like you. I said, how? She said, I discovered that I was born with it. And when I place my hand on people and do whatever, they heal. I said, but your own is coming from your ancestors. And your ancestors did something some years ago. You didn't know it. And inherited it in your blood. So it's not according to the prescription by God. I said, I am a minister of religion. I am saved. I said, for instance, are you saved? She said, not really, but she goes to church from time to time, whatever. But she hasn't gone in the past, whatever, for how long she has not gone. I said, that is the difference between both of us. I said, my own healing is based on the word of God. And that's how I heal people and do deliverance for them. But your own is not based upon that, and you hardly even go to church. So, and my own principle is different from your principle. So don't be carried away. Don't let somebody tell you, people in hotels in America, they have psychics on call, like a resident psychic, some have resident psychics. Are you listening to what I'm saying? Just like some hotels, we have the games room, the all kinds of, say that, other things that they set up in the hotels. And so when you come there, we say, oh, you know, we have games room. Oh, we have if you need a saloon, if you need this, we have them here. Some have psychics. Some have all kinds of, that I don't even want to mention here. Witchcraft people that you can use, you can consult. But they don't have chapel. We are Christian. We are pastors. You know, can come or counsel us that we help the people. They don't want the gospel. Somebody said something. I have to be rushing, and I'm sorry about that. But I want you to get the fact. Get the fact. Hallelujah. Somebody posted something on Caribbean 1 million Intercessors Network. There is something right now, if they touch you on your shoulder and say, oh, they are helping you to kill mosquito. It's not mosquito they are killing. They are putting drugs on you to knock you off so that they can do whatever they want to. And some stories were put there that somebody was in the supermarket and a male figure just from the back just touch her and say, oh, there was a big mosquito I was trying to kill. And she turned back and saw the man. Say, oh, yeah, I was trying to help. And by the time she was walking off to go to her car, she was going down. She was unconscious. They had to take her to the hospital. And from there, they said, when they checked the place where the person touched her, it was drugs. So I'm saying to someone, those of you that are listening to me online, and those of you that are right here, be careful. Wet yourself, soak yourself in the ocean of the blood of Jesus before you leave your house. Every day, every week, when you wake up, when you go to sleep, because the devil is coming to touch you. The devil is coming to book some. But rebuke him, rebuke him, rebuke him in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Rebuke the devil and he will flee. Let me tell you, this is not a time where we'll be fake. You have to be hot.
Yes.
Do not be hot and cold. No. Be hot. Consist. He knows. He will send his angels around you. Be serious about your Christian faith. Do not allow men and women to tarnish your image. Your body is the temple of the living God. Do not destroy. God has reward for those who will not destroy their temple, their body, with man or woman, in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Put your hands together for Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Well, what I'm saying to you today is, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Be strong in the Lord against all of this evil. Wage war against the powers of darkness. Wage war. I have to be running high, keep on to get something to wear today. I said, I'm not going to tell you before, but now I'm forced to say it. That's why I have to just put something on, because I'm like, oh my God, it's raining. Oh my God, it's not raining. We're going, oh my God, the rain has started again. Oh my God, you're going to, oh Jesus. So I just have to put something. Jesus, I put it on. You forgive me for that? I'm asking you, huh? Hallelujah. Pastors' lives are public. Let me tell you something. We just have to tell you. We just have to, and teach us too. But what am I saying? Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Don't let anybody touch you and let the thing knock you off. Wet yourself. Soak yourself in the ocean of the blood of Jesus. Wet yourself before you leave your house. I soak myself in the ocean of the blood of Jesus. Before you sleep, I soak myself in the ocean of the blood of Jesus. And don't you ever come out of it. And just before I started to preach, I saw the chair that I used to sit on while we were living on the hills, writing. I want to point you to some of my books. They will help you. Because some of these things are there. They will guide you. They will help you. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. Thank you. Jesus is God. Jesus is God. The Lord bless you. The Lord keeps you. The Lord make his eyes to shine upon you and give you peace. Help us to give towards the building of the construction of the Revival Village campsite. And the church right there. And also, I celebrate my 60th birthday on the 4th of November. And my son, 30th, the same day. So I'm asking people, if you want to give us gifts, call me. Or send, call me, I'll give you the account number and you can send it. Amen. God bless you. God bless you.
Do you like what you have been hearing? Do you find the discussion interesting? Please remember to like, subscribe, share, and hit that notification bell before you leave.